Hello again. Our next topic will be an interesting one. Having completed and pretty much perfected the difficult task of playing MIDI songs through a plugin in real time, we can now turn our attention to more spectacular things, like displaying the plugin's editor and providing a user-friendly, menu-driven user interface. In this project, the program will still remain a console application, but from here it is a small step to design a graphical user interface for it, if you feel so inclined. I'm not sure if it will surprise anyone, but a console application can still have windows. In fact, I'm going to start by showing you how I created a window for the plugins editor. The plugins editor is a graphical object that needs to be placed in a window our program generates. And what better way of doing this than following object-oriented principles and placing it in its own class? Hence this MIDI plugin editor class here. Much of the implementation is standard Windows, Win32 stuff. If you've ever done basic old-fashioned Windows programming, then this should look familiar. I don't know how this translates to something similar on the Mac or Linux, but I suspect it wouldn't be much different. I put this code in the constructor of the class, but that's not a requirement. It could just as well be in a subroutine. We need to get a handle to the application and store it in a variable, because this will be needed when the window is eventually unregistered and destroyed. So this method begins with registering the window class, and if successful, then we are ready to create the window. Of particular interest here is this line, where we ask the plugin to provide the dimensions of the edit control. It is done by making a call to the dispatcher with the relevant opcode. This also means that we need to have access to the plugin and the dispatcher in our plugin editor window, and that is why I have these two variables here, which are assigned values here. Back to create window. After the window has been created, it can be shown and the plugins editor opened in it. This is all very straightforward, but there are always some nuances to be taken care of, otherwise things don't work as expected. In this particular case, I found that for the plugins editor to display correctly, I had to pause the execution of the host program for a moment, so I added this timer. Here is the Windows message loop. This is where the window receives incoming messages, such as mouse clicks and various others, and dispatches them to the Windows procedure callback function. As you can see, the timer I kicked off further up gets handled here. Now, you might wonder what this fEditIdle opcode is doing here. I wonder too. So let's see what the VST SDK documentation says about it. Here it is. It says, no arguments. Fine. See also AEF editor idle. Idle call supported by host application. Well, we know that. Anyway, from my experience, this edit idle call gives the plugin's editor a chance to do some processing, like to update or refresh the display. Finally, here, when the window is closing, it receives a destroy message and the editor is closed. This is all there is to it in this class. What I want to do next is to show you how I reorganized the program to turn it into a proper application, albeit a simple one, an executable that can be given to someone to run and use. At the same time, I retained the ability to run this program from the debugger if I need to. Basically, I'm catering for a range of scenarios. To let me switch between them, I defined these preprocessor variables. Some plugins are 32-bit, others are 64-bit, and with this variable, certain sections of the code are enabled or disabled, as the case may be. When trace is on, information about the program's execution is displayed on the console as the program is running. You saw that in earlier videos. Dev is for running the program in the development environment when I want to use some hard-coded values. Finally, prod for production will be switched on when the program is compiled for use in a well-defined installation with a certain directory structure. This directory structure contains folders for plugins, MIDI files, and WAV output files. In the main function, I have an elaborate menu structure. Well, firstly, the program can be run either with command line parameters, as we saw it in the previous video, or interactively. By that I mean the user can choose from options in a menu. As you can see here, if the program was started without command line parameters, then the user is asked to choose a plugin, and then to choose a MIDI tune to play. However, if there were command line parameters, then the MIDI tune is played based on those. To save the audio output in a WAV file is optional. Here we arrive to the section where the menu is constructed. Here we have options to display plugin information, to play the MIDI tune, of course, or to save it in a WAV file. And, most excitingly, where the plugin's editor is opened. That editor window should open on a different thread so that the console window with the menu could still be used. Unfortunately, not all plugins can run on a separate thread. I wrote this function to check which ones can. You might not have experience in programming with threads, in which case there is a little extra learning to do. I might do a video on this topic, although chances are that it is already well covered by tutorials on the net. The editor window is opened here. This is where the MIDI plugin editor object is created, and we arrive at the code I showed you earlier. What remains, of course, is to see this program in action. So I'll shut up and let the thing to speak for itself.